I believe we are created for greatness, not mediocrity. That we are to live our lives accordingly, striving to be agents of change as we attempt to leave this world a better place than we found.
Hey there, welcome to a new edition, PLS Tips. I am your host, Manny Lopez. Today we have a super special edition, and if you're paying attention last week, you probably know what that is. You can probably already see it a little bit in the background there, but it is my daughter. Yes, she is born. So yeah, I had my daughter on Friday the 5th. What was really cool is that I actually got the time of date of birth right on time. I literally called it by the minute. The doctors were so amazed. I've got it on video. If I have enough time, I'll probably upload it to the channel. So feel free to check out the other videos. I'll upload it later. But if I have the ability, right now it's about 3:30 my time. I've got to get this finished, uploaded, edited, converted, and everything by 6 o'clock, which is usually, this is like a whole day project for me to get these done. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna have enough time to edit the video and get that snippet in there. But I want to see, I might be able to get in there. So if you may see it, you may not, but if...
808. Lower their bets on the door.
That's looking awesome. I called it 808. Wow. All
right,
that is cool.
Wow.
Can I take this off?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
How do you know?
That's my favorite number, and I just told her... Be born at 808.
See, listen.
Basically, what happened is about 10 hours before she was due. So, well, I'm going to backtrack a little bit. So, she went into labor at 8 o'clock in the morning. Okay. I just dropped off my kids at school. And she's like, hey, I just went in, you know, the water broke. And she started, you know, getting contractions, stuff like that. So, went to the hospital by about 9:30, 10 o'clock or so. And the doctors checked her, and she was only 1 centimeter dilated. She's been 1 centimeter dilated for like a week already. And so checked on her, and you know, just had her kind of sitting there and waiting. Waited all day till about 5 o'clock. They checked her again, and she was still about 1.5 dilated. So we're like, oh man, this is gonna be a long day. But then I talked to the doctor that morning, like in the morning, about 10 o'clock or so. I had mentioned to them, I was like, hey, that'd be really cool if the baby was born on 808, right? And because me, I'm just fascinated with eights. Everything has to have some type of correlation with eights. It's just my favorite number. I've had it forever, as long as I can remember. But I've always told my wife the last 6 months, like, literally, like, it'd be cool if she was born December 8th, because she was due the 15th. She wasn't even due for another 5 days. So I was like, it'd be cool if she was born December 8th at 808. Weighing 8 pounds, 8 ounces. Yeah, I literally called it. It was really awesome. So I wanted to share that and get some excitement out of it. I mean, that was really cool because I called it. The doctors were stunned. They were like, how did you just call it? I mean, that's the first time I've ever had that happen. And so I wanted to share that with you guys first off, and also share my beautiful princess. As you can see, she's sleeping right now. When she's awake, she's very active. Let me see if I can get a close-up. I don't know how close I can get this camera. I don't really move too much. Let me move her. Forget it. Bundle of joy. Look at her. Nice and close. There she is.
She's so cute.
She was 6 pounds, 13 ounces, 20 inches long, which is actually 1 foot, 8 inches long.
Cool, huh?
Born December 5th, 8:08 p.m. And yeah, she's amazing. Doesn't cry too much, only when she's hungry. She's always hungry. So as long as we have some food in her mouth, she is quiet. All right, well, anyways, let's get back to this training. This week, what is the topic this week? Oh, yeah, what motivates you? So, one of the reasons I want to show you this, because I want to show you what motivates me, what gets me to do what I do and do it to the fullest. You know, it's not a point of, you know, finding a passion, just doing it because you love to do it, but you have to have something that drives you, what motivates you, what gets you to wake up early, gets you to stay up late, to put in those extra hours. You have something that is on that dream board, something that's on that motivational track that's just getting you to say, you know, I'm not gonna give up. I'm not gonna give in because something's counting on me. Something is waiting for me to achieve that. And for me, my motivation is my family. My family. I've got two boys. I started my sales career very young. I used to sell door-to-door newspapers. I used to do car sales at 18. I've sold medical discount plans. I've sold debt consolidation. I've sold, you know, internet marketing. I've sold, I mean, really almost anything. Anything that has some type of sales to it, I loved it. I just love to be able to create my own income, to be able to say, you know, my efforts is what's going to produce my results. It's how much I'm going to get paid. I'm not stuck in an hourly wage that's going to say, no matter how much I produce, I'm making X amount per month. It doesn't matter. I like the fact that I can choose my income. And what motivated me the most is right after high school, you know, I'm actually married to my high school sweetheart. And after high school, I had gone into a lot of different sales. And my wife ended up, you know, the girlfriend at the time, ended up getting pregnant with our firstborn. And I was 19 years old at the time. So for me, it was like, man, I've got to get myself going because now I've got a kid to support. I've got a family to feed. It's not just by myself now. And for me, I was pretty old school myself. I don't see the fact of me having kids and then not, you know, taking care of that family, being there every single day. So as soon as she was pregnant, you know, I moved in with the family. I didn't have my own place yet. I was a young kid. I was working at McDonald's or working little side end jobs here and there just to try and, you know, go and get somewhere. So for me, I ended up start working sales because I saw that there was better income opportunity, and ended up, you know, getting into a point where I was making decent money. I was making a good amount of income to support my family, and, you know, I was getting paid off of my worth and what I could produce. And so for me, I just saw that, you know, every day I would come in and I would come in early, I'd work late, and it was all for that little mouth to feed, you know, always to show, you know, my family, hey, you know, there is a way for, you know, no matter where you come from. I came from nothing. You know, I didn't have rich family. I didn't have, you know, great education. I went to public high school and, you know, I didn't, you know, nothing special about my life that would give me any better opportunity over anybody else. I literally started from nothing and just said, you know what, I'm going to create my own way, and I needed something to motivate me, something to keep me going. And that is these little mouths to feed. It's to have the ability to say, you know what, you don't have to worry about where that next meal is coming from. You know, you don't have to worry about, you know, having to be able to choose between doing this or this because of financial problems or something like that. You know, there's always difficulty in what you have, but you gotta have drive and determination, motivation to say, no matter what obstacles I'm gonna face, I'm just gonna overcome them. It's gonna be easy because I don't have, you know, what's standing in front of me that's gonna be bigger than what my goals are. If you have an end goal, you have a vision at the end of the tunnel, you make sure that you keep your eye on that prize. You don't focus on the task in front of you because there's gonna be roadblocks no matter where you are in life, no matter how successful. I mean, look at myself. I mean, I could be, you know, a position of having great, great, you know, financial stability and stuff like that. And then all of a sudden a big curveball will come in and just throw everything for a loop. And then I've got to look at that situation and say, you know, am I gonna sit here and let it affect me? Am I gonna sit here and drown in my sorrows? Am I gonna sit here and think, oh man, the worst or worse is gonna happen even worse? No, I'm gonna say, great roadblock, whatever, jumping right over that. And let's say, great, another challenge I can learn from. The benefit I've seen a lot of what I've been able to do, and how I've been able to overcome, you know, some of the obstacles I've faced is I take a look at each obstacle as a challenge. You know, I see it as something that, it's something for me to learn from. It's something, it's a lesson in life. You know, they say in school, they first teach you the lesson and then give you the test, right? And then you're able to be graded from that. So they're going to teach you what it is, and then you actually get the test on it. Now, in real life, it's practically the opposite. You know, you're going to get the test first, okay? And that test is going to test whether or not you're going to take which path you're going to go. Are you going to, you know, fail and let it take you down? Or are you going to, you know, overcome that adversity, even if it's something negative, even if it's something that doesn't, you know, get to where you want to be. So that's where you have to look at. You know, don't let it affect you to where you let it take you down. you know, Barbara Corcoran. I don't know if you know this. If you watch Shark Tank, it's a TV show for people that are outside of the United States. It's a TV show in the United States that's based on, you know, an outside country's original type of layout. I forgot what it's originally called. But basically, entrepreneurs go in there, they talk about their business model, and they try to get investments from angel investors, the sharks. They call them sharks. So, you know, they go into the Shark Tank, pitch their product, and they say whether or not, you know, they will invest or not in that business. And one really stood out to me. I'm not going to say the name of it, but the story really hit home. And this could, you know, may resonate with you. But what happened was, is that the guy came in there and his business was doing pretty well to start off with, hit some snags, ended up putting the business on the shelf for a couple years, and then came back in the Shark Tank and wanted to get that business back off the ground, but needed the capital to get it going, to get it to the higher levels, to get inventory, to get, you know, to get it back up to where it was before and get it to those higher levels. And so they asked him, you know, why did you just sit on this? What happened? You know, why did you just work on this, hit some snags and gave up, you know, and then now you're back here. You want us to invest in this business. You know, why should we even invest our time? So he goes and starts talking about the story about him and his daughter. Okay. So his daughter runs track, some type of sport, right, at school. And she was having adversity with the, you know, the sport, and she wasn't doing well. You know, a lot of people were doing well better than her. And, you know, she was just getting discouraged more and more every day. And, you know, she got it to a point where she wanted to give up. And she was talking to her dad about it. And she's like, you know, I don't even want to do it anymore. It's just not worth it. It's just, it's too much adversity. It's too much complication. It's just not, you know, I don't want to do it anymore. It's not fun. It's not easy, you know? So he told her, well, why are you going to give up now? It makes no sense. I mean, you're this close to finishing high school with this. You mean, you may be able to go to college and get scholarships from this and be able to look at this as something that, you know, you want to do. I know it's hard right now, but you got to get through it. Just chuck through it. And she tells him, why should I keep trying, Dad? I mean, look at you. You gave up on your passion. I mean, and that really hit home to him. So he was like, wow, you know, I'm setting the example here. I mean, I didn't notice that they take a look at that. They're watching me. They're looking at what I do in my business. And they see that, you know, I gave up years ago on my passion just because it became too difficult. It became harder for me to realize that, yes, I could use this, or yeah, I can do this, to a point to where you're like, you just gave up. And for him, that's what motivated him to get him back into his business, because he said, you know what, I'm not going to give up because I've got other people looking at me. And that's the same with me, myself. I've got three people now, four people, you know, my wife included, that are looking to me and looking at me and saying, you know, you're the example for this family. You are the breadwinner. You're the one who's taking care of us. You're the one that is deciding whether or not we are going to eat. And that's a lot of responsibility on me. And even if I'm a young guy, 27 years old now, but, you know, started at 19 years old, I knew that I had to make my own way, and I had to find a way to make sure that I can always provide for my family. And I went at the corporate ladder initially because I just felt that's the safest way to do it. Like most people going out there do, is they just go to some business or some corporation that's already established that will pay them a salary or a commission or something like that to be able to go out there and make sales or work for them. And so that's what I did. I was trying to get myself to a position where I can manage a team. And so I went to a lot of sales organizations to try to make myself up the ladder, because everywhere they go, you know, they say, be the best of our best and we'll promote you. So that's what I tried to do. And, you know, it just didn't work out. I just was never given that opportunity. So I ended up creating my own. And, you know, that's where I'm at today. It's just, I created my own way, found my own way to make my niche in the marketplace. And we're doing very well. And I'm ecstatic for that. So now I want to make sure I'm helping you guys. It's really showing you guys how to find your motivation. For me, that's my family. It's for me to find what drives me. Anytime I'm down, anytime things are not going my way, anytime I've hit a snag in my business, you know, I contemplate about that missed opportunity or that structure that we should have had in place beforehand. But then I see that's a learning opportunity. It's a way for me to see that if I don't do things this way, this is going to happen. Or if I do things this way, this is going to happen. You just, for every, you know, thing that you do, there's going to be a consequence to it, whether good or bad. So, you know, sometimes it's going to be bad. You just never know. You may bring on a client that just doesn't, you know, sit well with your business, or you may bring on a team member that promote your business wrong. You may bring on, you know, someone that's unethical. You just don't know who you're doing business with. You know, you just don't know who you're bringing on your team, or you just don't know, you know, the situation that you may be in. So you just have to look at each position that you're in as a learning experience. This, you know, this type of experience that I have will give me this type of result. And you have to go through trial and error to get that. So you have to understand that you are going to have growing pains in your business. It does not matter how great your business is or how easy your business is. You're going to have problems. You're going to have people to deal with. You're going to have situations to deal with. You're going to have something that goes wrong that should not go wrong. And what's going to get you over that hump is for you to see that you have a motivational thing that's behind you. You have something that's going to drive you. And you focus on that drive. You focus on what's gonna make you successful. You focus on the money-making activities. You focus on what's keeping you positive. The negative is only gonna drown you even more. It's gonna make you hinder your growth. It's not gonna help you step forward. You know, as long as you're stepping, you know, one step back, you gotta step three steps forward. You know, you gotta make sure you get that one step back, and you're also gaining more than double on that return. Okay, so, you know, that's my main focus to you. It's just, don't let people or situations cloud your dreams and your vision, your passion. You know, everybody's got a motivational drive, you know, something that's gonna keep them excited about life, excited about going and doing things and becoming who you wanna be. You can't just sit there and let other people dictate your future, you know? For me, this little bundle of joy and those two in the room right there, you know, that's it for me, man. That's all I need to keep me motivated. Keep me driven, keep me saying, you know what, I'm gonna push that much harder. I'm gonna make a couple extra phone calls, you know, because that one call could be a make or break situation. Like recently, you know, we just secured a new sales office for my business, and I'm really excited about it. It was crazy that we literally locked that deal the exact day that she was born. So that's gonna be something great to remember. But, you know, it's just an opportunity that came by out of nowhere, because of a phone call, because of that one extra phone call. And you just never know who's gonna be able to connect on the line that's just gonna make a big difference in what your goals are doing. Man, she's literally like farted like four times. I don't know if you can hear them. You probably can, but if you can hear them, it's not me, I swear, it's her. she's so cute though. That's what I want to share with you guys is, you know, just get motivated, find what motivates you, focus on that passion, focus on that drive, focus on what's going to keep you looking towards the stars, looking towards that future financial goal. You know, you got to write out your goals, write out what you want to accomplish in the next 5 years. You know, you got to have a situation that you know that you're going to be better in. You can't just wing it and keep thinking, oh, well, if I just, you know, make an extra couple calls here and there. You know, hey, I'll attend another networking event sometime in the future. No, you literally map it out and strategize, because, you know, if you don't make a plan, then you're just planning to fail. So that's what I think would be great to resonate with you guys this week. Focus on finding what motivates you and really make sure that is keeping you driven on your passion, on getting to where you want to go. If it's a monetary goal, if it's a place that you want to go, you've always wanted to travel. You know, a lot of the things that people are going to have a goal in life is going to be somehow stuck to monetary. You know, it may not be, you know, monetary as in, you know, I need to make $10,000. You know, that's not something that you want to have a goal on. You want to have a goal that's going to accomplish, you know, a bucket list item in your life. And a lot of times that's going to be requiring financial freedom. That's going to require time off of work. That's going to require, you know, income just to maybe go to that place and travel to that place, or buy that item for your mom, or, you know, buy a house for your mom. Maybe that's a goal. You know, everybody's got something that's going to drive them. And if you have that driven motivation, nothing's going to be able to step in your way. You know, you can be able to do anything you want. So focus on that, guys. We've got a lot of great topics. I wanted you to meet my princess, and just, you know, let me know what I can do to help you. Like I said, this, you know, those PLS tips is not just for me to show you how great I can tell you guys how to do things and share my strategies, but it's really getting you guys to understand your worth and your value. Everybody's got a story to share. Everybody's got something of value that people are going to find and attract to. That's 7 billion people in this world. You only need a fraction of a 1% to give yourself financial freedom. That's it. A fraction of 1%, not even 1%. You don't even need that many people. A tenth of a hundredth of 1%, and you can just change the world. It's crazy. So, you know, take into account all the benefits that you can do and what you can do to this world. And just let it drive you. Let it motivate you. Let somebody find value in what you do. And they're going to shout to the rooftops how great you are. So, you know, get out there, you know, provide incentive and content and value to people. And you're going to see how much it comes back to you. So I love it. Oh, she's smiling. You see that? You see that? I think I got it. I'm going to zoom in on that. I got her to smile yesterday when I told her she was pretty. I always tell her, you're so pretty, baby. You're so pretty. And got her to smile from it. So that's pretty cool. I'm going to be showing you guys more of her all the time, man. I just love holding her and hanging out with her. She's really cool. As long as she's quiet and not screaming at me and not pooping on me. I mean, literally, I don't know what it is, but this baby, every time I change her, it's like, oh, that's my cue to go take a poop and pee again. I mean, literally, every time I've either gotten pooped on or peed on again. And while I'm changing her, it's like ridiculous. I don't know why. I either pick the worst times or she's just messing with me. I don't get it. But anything that you guys need, please let me know. You see my cell phone number right below here. You know, if you want to reach out to me, got the chat feature below. If you're not able to log in, we only allow 10 people to log in there at a time. So if you can't log in, please text me, you know, send me a text message, say, hey man, I can't log in the chat feature, but I had a question for you. You know, how does this work with PLS? Whatever. If you guys need a walkthrough video on how to do a certain feature, you're like, hey, I'd love to learn how to do a hangout, or I'd love to learn how to, you know, utilize this contact manager more. Let me know. I'd love to do, you know, just walkthrough videos on how to do certain things. And for me, I just don't want to have to sit here and try and think of ideas. If you guys need some help, message it to me, send me a text message, let me know. I'll make it, print it on here, so that way you guys can share it. And you know, start getting some stuff with your team. If you have team members that need help on marketing, on strategizing, on getting out there and getting the word out, have them watch this training. Get this, go to your share codes and copy the share code. It's 201-426-PLS-TIPS. Okay. Use that share code. It'll copy my PLS tips into your back office, then just assign it to whatever domain you want. And every single week, it'll update with my new coaching. And you can send that to your team. And then if they go to it and they want to sign up, it'll write back into your account. So they'll go right to signing up for you guys. So you can send it to your prospects. Your prospects can copy that and send that to their team. So it gives you the ability to duplicate this very easy. Okay. So check that out. I'm going to wrap that up today because I got to get this edited and uploaded and converted within the next 2 hours. So this will be fun. Good luck. Any help you guys need, just let me know. And you guys have a great weekend, great holiday. I will see you guys next week, Wednesday, 6 p.m. Pacific time, 9 p.m. Eastern time. Have a good day. We'll talk to you soon.
I believe we are created for greatness, not mediocrity. That we are to live our lives accordingly, striving to be agents of change as we attempt to leave this world a better place than we found it.